Greetings, AC family. One of the most common questions I get asked is, how does one get into ant keeping? How do you start? Where do I get ants for an ant farm? Well, the answer to that is simple. You start in your own backyard or neighborhood. In my case, I started right in the area where I grew up, near the Humber River in Toronto, Canada. And today, I've come back home from halfway across the world to show you how to locate the seeds of an ant farm. Today, AC family, as I've done for years growing up, we hunt for queen ants. Please subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon. Welcome to the AC family. Enjoy. Everyone has that one place that holds memories of their childhood, that one special location we call home and love coming back to. Well, mine is right here, at my family's home in the suburbs of Toronto. It's where I started ant keeping, and the place my entire journey as AntsCanada began. It was here where I housed my very first ant colonies, where I started this YouTube channel, where I began making ant farms and ant keeping products to sell online, and where my ant love truly began. A lot of people have asked why this channel is called AntsCanada, when I continually mention my home base and antiverse being in Manila, Philippines. And well, now you know why. I moved to Manila in 2011 for one of my other career pursuits. But AC family, today, now that I'm in Toronto, I wanted to take you through the fun and exciting process of how I find queen ants. Because I know a lot of you are from geographically similar areas and want to start ant keeping yourselves. So this video will cover what I do to find queen ants to start an ant farm every spring and summer in temperate North America. To begin the hunt, you need the proper hunting equipment. Some snap cap vials. You can buy these in most dollar stores or arts and craft shops. Any small bottle or container will do. But I love these because I can easily poke breathing holes at the tops so the queens can breathe and can easily fit into any pocket. Later, you'll also need some test tubes like these to place the queen ants in for incubation. But please excuse these used dirty test tubes. They're long overdue for a cleaning, and I never got around to cleaning them since I left 7 years ago. But now, AC family, it's off to the hunting grounds. I find the best time to look for queen ants is right before noon, around 11 a.m., to early afternoons before 3 p.m. Different species have their nuptial flights at different times of the day, but I have always found most of my queen ants within this 11 a.m. to 3 p.m. time period. Also, looking on the right day is key. A sunny day after a rainstorm is the most ideal time to go hunting for queen ants, because this is when most ants have their nuptial flights. It had just rained the day before, so I was confident we'd find something. By the way, if you're new to the world of ants, here's a quick crash course on ant reproduction. During a period of a few days each year, every species has their designated week or so that they have what are called nuptial flights, where young queens and males who are born with wings, known as alates, fly en masse and mate in the air. The males die after this nuptial flight, and queens fall to the ground, break off their wings, and embark on a search for a location underground to start their own ant colonies. It is during this period after mating when newly impregnated queens are searching for a nesting location that we ant keepers have to snag them for our ant farms. It is truly like catching a real-life Pokemon, and it requires a mixture of skill, knowledge, a good eye, and a bit of luck. And now, AC family, welcome to my ancestral queen ant hunting grounds. I love coming here. The Humber River Trail is a popular bike path on the west side of Toronto, offering bike riders, joggers, and walkers an easy yet long route alongside a steady flowing river and deciduous forest. The river is home to a variety of fish and aquatic creatures and attracts a vast array of birds, animals, and of course, insects, including ants. I love searching along paths like this because it forces creatures to come out into the open in plain sight as they move towards and away from the river. I find it perfect for spotting wandering, freshly mated queen ants. Walking along the path now, the first thing I notice are not queen ants, but rather tons and tons of caterpillars. It's officially caterpillar season. Moths have laid their eggs,
and from them have hatched caterpillars which spin massive cottony webs in the trees. These caterpillar web nests formed when the caterpillars were babies, but are abandoned now. The caterpillars' droppings are the only evidence left behind of their previous inhabitation. AC family, isn't it just amazing to think that not only spiders spin webs, but so do caterpillars? Look at these caterpillars hanging from their web lifelines. Sometimes caterpillars will fall out of their trees, or even jump out to evade a predator like a bird, and will hang from their lifeline webs like these, making them seem like they are floating vertically in mid-air. I had to watch out not to run into these hanging caterpillars while walking along the path on my search for queen ants. The caterpillars are voracious herbivores, eating up leaves like crazy. When they've completely eaten up the leaves of one tree or bush, they will emigrate to another. And with it being caterpillar season, it seems this Humber River Trail path is a busy caterpillar crossing. Sadly, crossing this great path happens to be a life-threatening risk for the caterpillars and other creatures crossing, for it is a path through which giants stampede and ride. Some who are lucky enough make it across to the other side, but as for the unlucky others, the path is littered in their flattened carcasses. But these flattened corpses are feasts for certain creatures inhabiting the area, including ants. Is this huge ant a queen? Nope, she's just a big super major worker carpenter ant, Camponotus pennsylvanicus. She's found a squashed ground beetle. Sadly, this cool and giant species of ant had their nuptial flights last month in Toronto and is no longer flying, but I always love watching them. Various other Camponotus species continue to fly in North America and Europe until around September. Camponotus species, also known as carpenter ants, make great pet ants because they are so large, so they and their brood are easy to see with the naked eye and are quite active. The only drawback I see with carpenter ants is their colonies usually take 2 or 3 years to reach an impressive size. Patience is truly required when housing these girls. If you go back to some of my first videos on this channel, I had an amazing colony of Camponotus noveboracensis, the New York carpenter ant, still one of my favorite ant colonies to date. I had to release them back into the wild when I moved to Manila 8 years ago, but I often wonder how they've been holding up today. They must be a massive ant colony by now. I truly hope to find a Camponotus noveboracensis. Let's see. Walking along the path, I also ran into my very first species of ant I've ever kept on this channel. AC family, behold, Myrmica ants. Here I caught them tending to some plant aphids, like ant cows, which they ferociously protect and milk for their sweet secretions called honeydew. These extremely aggressive ants, though a different genus from the popular true fire ants of the genus Solenopsis, have adapted the name fire ants because of their stings. To be honest, I've been stung by these Myrmica ants many times while keeping them. And honestly, in my opinion, their bites are much more painful than those of the Fire Nation, my tropical fire ants at home. Now, if you want to keep a colony of Myrmica, here is a hack, AC family. I find the best way is to collect a mature colony, as opposed to catching a single queen ant, and I'll explain why in a bit. The good news is, their nests are almost always shallow, usually under some wood, leaves, or rock, so scooping them up is easy. Also, another awesome advantage is, if you scoop up as much of the colony as possible, you're bound to scoop up at least one queen, or 20. You see, Myrmica ants are polygynous, meaning their colonies usually contain dozens, if not hundreds, of egg-laying queens. After their nuptial flights, the newly impregnated queen ants of this species band together, founding big colonies cooperatively. So, unlike most ants, where collecting an established colony from the wild almost always leaves you without a queen ant because the workers hide her so well, collecting the majority of the ants of a Myrmica nest almost always guarantees the capture of a queen. They also hunt during the colony founding stage, which makes it a bit more complicated for the average beginner ant keeper. So catching an already established Myrmica colony may be easier than collecting a bunch of queen ants and placing them in a test tube. But if you're gonna go collecting Myrmica ants, remember to wear gloves. Trust me, stings from these girls are no joke. It hurts a lot. If you go back to the oldest videos of this channel, you can follow my journey with my first Myrmica ant colony. They're such an interesting species that love wet nests and lots of insects and sweets. If you love watching collective ant aggression, these are the ants for you. All right, AC family, I know what you're thinking. All this talk, but still no queen ants. I know, it's strange. But hey, sometimes this happens. Some days are dry, and queen ants scarce. I resolved to come back and try another day. Day two of queen ant hunting. Again after a great rainstorm. And I was hopeful to find something. It wasn't long before I spotted something along the path that I was sure was a queen ant. But AC family, as I took a closer look, this is what I saw. Do you see it? Do you guys know what this is? This looks like a queen ant with its enlarged thorax. But actually, this is not an ant at all. It's not even an insect. This is a spider. It's an ant mimic. This is actually the first time I've seen one here in Toronto, as I usually see them in more tropical climates. What looks like the head of the queen ant is actually the spider's chelicerae, its mouthparts. There are over 300 species of spiders in different families that mimic ants. Looking like an ant is advantageous because most predators know that ants taste gross and or are aggressive. So a predator like a toad, for instance, might see this spider, believe it's an ant, and decide it's not worth eating. This type of mimicry where a creature mimics a harmful or undesirable animal is called Batesian mimicry. Thanks to Batesian mimicry and ants' notorious reputation, this spider is more likely to outlive the average ordinary looking spider. I continued to look and search. No queens were in sight. In fact, I searched on two more days, and though there were lots and lots of caterpillars, there was no sign of a queen ant anywhere. This can be a common frustration in ant keeping. Sometimes, like I did last year, you can catch many, and sometimes you come up empty-handed. But it's a matter of persistence and not giving up. Sadly, by the time you watch this, I will be on my 16-hour flight back to Manila, Philippines, and regretfully, queenless. But you know what, AC family? Even if I wasn't lucky, many of you AC family members from around the world have been. Behold, your epic queen ant catches.
Here is my Campanadas colony. Just got my first soldier. Plenty of eggs. Got some pupae in there still.
Hello, my name is Guy Kruger, and I've caught 5 Tetramorium species E, and I live in Salt Lake City.
These all my ant queens. These 3 are called Vidoli. This one, however, is called Rhodomimix.
This is my queen, Solenopsis xyloni, and I'm really excited for her first group of workers.
2 photos of the second queen. I believe they're of the same species.
It's my fire ant queen, scientifically known as Solenopsis geminata.
Don't know the name of the species.
The eggs are maturing.
I caught this queen about 2 weeks ago. Anyways, bye.
It's ant love forever. Alright, AC family, did you enjoy this week's video? I hope it helped some of you out there looking for queen ants of your own this year. In last year's queen ant hunting video, I was much more lucky. Feel free to watch it here. If you were like me and haven't found a queen ant yet, trust me on this. You have nothing to worry about. There is still lots of time, as the ants will continue to have nuptial flights all summer long, well into fall. Good luck and keep looking. I guarantee you will surely find the queen ant of your dreams. And when you do, treasure and care for her with all your heart. AC family, on my flight back home, I will not be able to stop thinking about the black dragons and their disappearance 2 weeks ago, while I've been away. I will finally be able to get to the bottom of it, so be sure to hit that subscribe button and bell icon now, so you don't miss out on the update. And hit the like button every single time, including now. Also, if you're new to the channel and want to catch up on all your AntsCanada lore, I've put together a complete storyline playlist, so you can watch how all of the ant colonies you love on this channel came to be, all their challenges and hardships, all their successes and life events. Their entire storylines can now be watched from the very start, so you can better appreciate the journey these ants, as well as us watching them, have been embarking on. It's incredible how epic the lives of ants are. And also, just a quick reminder to all those wanting to get into ant keeping, we offer a ton of cutting-edge, easy-to-use ant keeping gear and pro ant farms at our shop at AntsCanada.com for when you do catch your queen ants this year. We ship worldwide and offer full email customer support if you need it. AC Inner Colony, I have left a hidden cookie for you here if you would just like to watch extended play footage of the creatures seen along this nature trail. Before we continue with the AC question of the week, I would like to plug my daily vlogging channel, daily vlogs of my travels around the world, which often includes a lot of nature stuff. Feel free to watch and subscribe while you're there. And now it's time for the AC question of the week. Last week, we asked, what was your favorite creature spotted in this rainforest, and why? Congratulations to El Reino de las Hormigas, who answered, my favorite creature of this video was Odontomachus, because they remind me of the Jawbreakers. Congratulations, El Reino de las Hormigas. You just won a free ebook handbook from our shop. In this week's AC question of the week, we ask, why is a path like that in this video a great location to find queen ants? Leave your answer in the comments section, and you could also win a free ebook handbook from our shop. Hope you can subscribe to the channel as we upload every Saturday at 8 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. Please remember to like, comment, share, and subscribe if you enjoyed this video to help us keep making more. It's Ant Love Forever.